In terms of laws that you feel you ought to be pushing once you become senator, if you become senator, no? How else can you improve on the Universal Health Care Act, for example, which is now law? And if you follow the provisions, actually, it's not a bad law at all, especially as it legislates a national insurance system, which has yet to materialize. No, but what exactly can you do if you sit as senator to make sure that this law is actually enforced to the letter and according to the intent for which it was actually passed?
Okay, that's a good question. There are two elements. One is PhilHealth and one is the UHC law itself. Okay, PhilHealth is the carrot and the stick of the UHC. Without a good PhilHealth, it's impossible. Okay, the UHC law, part of it tells us that PhilHealth will be increasing our premiums that we pay every year, every so often, until we're paying 5% of our salary, no? If you make 100,000. For me, that has to be put on TRO muna, hold muna, because I know for a fact PhilHealth is not collecting properly. Why are we suffering? We are going to suffer. The people who are paying, the ordinary employee is going to be paying more. Kakaltasan mas malaki. While inside PhilHealth, they're not even collecting properly. It's a very small percentage of what they should be collecting. Some of it goes to the treasury, some of it does not. Some of it goes somewhere else. Okay, there's so much that has to be fixed inside. There has to be an audit.
So you're saying it's a okay. So corruption. It's the problem, one of corruption.
One of corruption, one.
Lack of enforcement or funds for that matter.
That's one, no? That's one. And the system, okay? There must be an audit. We should make it a law. There must be an audit, regular audit of an independent body that will audit not just the finances of PhilHealth, but the IT system and their legal system. Because those are the two most problematic divisions of PhilHealth. The IT system, a lot of hospitals are complaining they're not getting paid. But if you see their records, it's as if they're being paid. What's happening to that money? Why is it like that? And I know that this government for a while tried to audit them, but they didn't allow themselves to be audited. How can that be? They cannot say don't audit us.
But Doc, hindi ba trabaho ng trabaho ng COA yun?
Yeah, but that's not the job of a senator.
Not senator, but there must be a law to make sure it is, there's an audit. It's not COA. COA audits the finances. Audit the IT system. An independent IT expert, the information technology, they must be able to open it up. The law has to be amended. It's not in the law. There's no transparency. They don't have to. There's too much secrecy inside PhilHealth. What's going on? Because you see, PhilHealth is a quasi-judicial. They are the investigator. They are the lawyers. They are the judge of everything. Okay. So we have to look into all of these things, no? Because we have to look into the law, and we have to see also how it's being implemented, because a lot of hospitals are also complaining on how it's being implemented. And I agree, no? For example, there's abuse. You know, there's a lot of populism. You know, the intention of the universal healthcare is this: no Filipino will go into financial ruin or just because you got sick. Okay, now. The idea is prevention. The idea is in every barangay, you will have your free maintenance medicines, your hypertension medicines, diabetes medicines, etc. So you don't end up having renal failure. You don't end up having a heart attack. You prevent that. You prevent hospitalization. But if you need to be hospitalized, there's a referral system, referral network, so you can get into a hospital assigned to you. Okay, then after you're through there, you go back. If it works, it's beautiful. It's beautiful, no? And if you go to a basic package, you don't pay. It's only if you get more than the basic, then you pay a copay. And the copay should be at least something predictable. Maganda talaga ang intention ng universal healthcare. But then, this is it. We can help our LGUs achieve that, especially since the Mandanas ruling of the Supreme Court will be in effect, okay? And EO 138 has been signed. So that money should go to them. However, there must be oversight very close oversight, and the Senate can do that, of how it's being implemented. There must be accountability, there must be deliverables, and we must see that if we give you this money, ito ang deliverables ninyo. So it's full devolution of the funds, okay, finally, not just the functions.